Exactly 100 years ago, the world record for the 100 meters was 10.6 seconds. Back then, people believed this was the human limit, impossible to break. In 1968, multiple sprinters finally broke the 10-second barrier. And in 2009, Usain Bolt stunned the planet with 9.58 seconds, a record that still stands today. But here's the question, is this really the limit of human speed, or could we one day run even faster? To understand why humans are limited in speed, we need to look at our anatomy. Every sprinter relies on muscle fibers. Fast twitch fibers for explosive power, slow twitch fibers for endurance. Sprinters are packed with fast twitch fibers, but they fatigue quickly. Marathoners rely on slow twitch, but they're weaker. Most of us are somewhere in between. And here's the problem. In humans, our calf muscles are heavy and sit low on the leg. That means every stride is like swinging a weight back and forth. Cheetahs, horses, even domestic dogs don't have this problem. Their muscles sit higher up the leg, while long tendons act like springs. This keeps their lower legs light and fast. That's the first big disadvantage. Our legs are designed for power and stability, not for raw speed. The start of a sprint is everything. Exploding out of the blocks, pushing the ground back with massive force. Studies show that the best sprinters generate higher horizontal force relative to their body weight. It's not just about how strong you are, it's how efficiently you push against the ground in the right direction. Biomechanics models show sprinting speed depends on step frequency times, step length times average ground force. Elite athletes maximize all three. But for the average human, our muscles and joints simply can't apply force quickly enough to keep increasing speed. Imagine speed as a simple equation. Steps per second times stride length. For humans, the limit seems to be about 5 steps per second with an average stride of 2.5 meters. That equals 12.5 meters per second, or 45 kilometers per hour. That's almost exactly where Usain Bolt peaked. But even he couldn't sustain it for more than a few seconds. New research suggests that if humans could apply force to the ground more quickly, our muscles might theoretically handle up to 64 kilometers per hour. But here's the catch. Most mammals are still way ahead. Cheetahs can double that speed. Even horses and dogs can easily outrun us in a sprint. Muscles don't just produce movement, they produce heat. And here's the shocking part. Only about 20% of the energy from our muscles turns into motion. The other 80% becomes heat. That heat has to go somewhere. If not, your body literally shuts down. Humans solved this problem with sweating. Unlike most mammals, our bare skin and millions of sweat glands allow us to release heat efficiently. This makes us terrible sprinters, but brilliant endurance runners. Because while a cheetah overheats in under a minute, we can keep going hour after hour under the blazing sun. This leads to the evolutionary theory known as the endurance running hypothesis. Early humans weren't built to outsprint gazelles. Instead, we used persistence hunting, chasing prey slowly but relentlessly until it collapsed from exhaustion. Over time, our bodies adapted. Longer legs, flexible Achilles tendons, two-gear locomotion, walking on flat feet for efficiency, running on toes for power. We may not have claws, fangs, or speed, but in a hot climate, we could run almost any animal into the ground. Today, we test these limits on the track. Usain Bolt's 9.58 is legendary. Some scientists predict a theoretical human limit around 9.4 seconds, maybe 9.3. That means the record could still fall. But here's the real evidence of our superpower. In 2005, ultra-runner Dean Karnazes ran 563 kilometers without stopping. That's 80 hours of continuous running. Modern ultramarathons see athletes run hundreds of kilometers in a matter of days. No cheetah, no horse, no wolf could match that. Not because we're fast, but because we simply never stop. So, can humans run faster than Bolt? Maybe a little, but not much. Our anatomy, our mechanics, and our limits are real, but speed was never our greatest weapon. Our true advantage is endurance. We are not the fastest species on Earth, but when it comes to running farther, longer, and harder than anyone else, humans are the ultimate runners of the animal kingdom. And if you want to dive into more strange science, hit subscribe to Curio Flux, because trust me, we run faster when you're watching.